When it comes to jewelry, some say diamonds are a girl's best friend. But during the pandemic, has that friend been shunned? We will find out as we focus on jewelry sales in India during the pandemic. And as the festive season approaches, what can we expect? What has been the pandemic's effect on your business? If you could share some numbers with us.
The pandemic's effects on jewelry have been actually very, very encouraging, far better than we had imagined. In the last few months, ever since the Zoya stores have been up and running, we have seen a 90% recovery for Zoya, which certainly is beyond our expectations. For overall jewelry business, which is for Tanishq, the main brand, we have seen a close to 80% like-to-like recovery in the last few months. And it is certainly very, very encouraging. Perhaps because jewelry is timeless, perhaps because there is a stored value, in the asset of jewelry, it doesn't, depreciate. In fact, it appreciates over time. And perhaps because gold itself has become a very strong safe haven.
The pandemic's effect, we really felt hard in the early days. March was literally down to about 30%, and April was zero sales. We managed to have the sales pick up really early on. I had our first ever sample sale in May, and that was the best month we've ever recorded in the 5 years of our business.
I think in India, there's just been a couture jewelry brand which has been missing. We wanted to create something which is completely new, something like how Cartier or Bulgari have a very deep-rooted design aesthetic to themselves. How the pandemic has affected us is it has actually not affected us that much because it's a very young, very new brand. And we have grown, in fact, in this time period, in the last 2-3 months, we have had some jewelry sales, surprising for us as well. But I think when there is originality, people are willing to buy.
All right. And what's your outlook? Are the sales going to pick up due to the festive season? What are you expecting?
Festive sales are likely to pick up closer to festive season. It's too early. We've had some small festive sales with Varamahalakshmi and, the Raksha Bandhan, Tij, etc. But those were very, very small in number. During festive, as usual, we expect a lot of people to come out and buy because people have been down for a long time. They would like to, experience positivity. And jewelry purchase is always a strong pull during festive. So we expect festival sales to be very good. And to kind of ensure that we don't let up or let down our customers, we are continuing with our plans with launching new collections, both in Zoya and Tanishq. Very exciting collections, very fresh, very new, which we think will really excite customers. So we expect during quarter three, not only the benefit of festival season, but also a strong wedding season. Because a lot of weddings from quarter one have got postponed into quarter three and quarter four. So overall, yes, we are keeping our fingers crossed that we see a fantastic quarter three.
The outlook is positive. There's a lot of COVID fatigue worldwide. So people are trying to move back to their daily lives. In India especially, we seem to be in denial that there's a pandemic out there. We're happy to be distracted. And in any case, jewelry is something that people see as an investment. So they're happy to treat themselves to that.
We believe in a slow business model for our couture jewelry brand because we are here for the long run. And we want to create a legacy out of this couture jewelry brand, which is very, very fine. We are very obsessive about our jewelry. So we sometimes take 5-7 CAD drawings to to get like a liberation necklace where wings are flying, or jewelry is like pieces of culture. It's almost like pieces of art that somebody is investing into. And all the young brides today and our couture clientele is looking for something that unique, that original, and something that they would want to have and pass on as heirlooms. I think as things are opening up, people are willing to spend, and more the reason that they're spending on themselves, because they cannot have that big fat Indian wedding with 500 people or 1,000 people wedding, etc. So now there's 100 people wedding. So they want to really feel themselves. They want to spend on clothes and jewelry.
With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Weekending. Have a great week. See you next weekend.